Hello friends, Ms. Espinosa here. Today I am going to share briefly what I have in my teacher closet. This summer I did make a video about 30 classroom must-have supplies. So in that list, I included things that you need in the classroom like for your students. So today I just want to share what I have for my teacher supplies. Here we go. So I will just start with the top shelf. This is my organized chaos. So this bin I got at Target at the dollar store a few years ago, and I just wanted a spot where I can put my stickers and name tags. So this is what is in here, just a bunch of stickers and name tags. These two bags were given to me by a previous kinder teacher, so it just has like extra little work in there. So this Osmo was given to me by the early childhood department my first or second year when I was teaching pre-K. And I think this was one of like the first kits that Osmo came out with. And if you're not familiar, I will link them in the description. You have to download the Osmo apps that go with each game. I have 4 games in here. It's like a very interactive way to learn letters and numbers. I have not used it in kinder yet. I think this little light I bought, I think my third year teaching, and I use it like for dance parties. And the batteries have lasted forever, and the colors change by themselves. This is a night light that I got from Amazon when I was teaching pre-K. It was nap time. I liked to put this little night light kind of in the middle of the classroom so the kids could just stare up at the stars while they're falling asleep, and they really enjoyed that. And here I have more red and white pockets. I love red and white pockets. Can't have enough of these in the classroom, especially this year with COVID and having individual work for the students. This bin I ended up with somehow. I did not purchase it, but it just has some of my teacher supplies, which is a hole puncher, stapler, rubber bands, a single hole puncher, staples, sticky notes, and magnetic tape, and these little Lakeshore erasers for dry erase boards. I have some random yarn, envelopes. The school did purchase a printer for us last year, so I take it out whenever I actually need it to print, but since I don't have a lot of furniture this year, I decided to just keep it in the closet. And luckily we also got some printing ink. I did buy an iPhone charger for my kids' iPads since most of my kids have iPads this year. And the really cool thing about this came with a couple of them, I think for like $13, and it has the double USB port so I can be charging two at a time. The school also got us a laminating machine, so this is the laminating machine that I keep here at school. But I keep my own personal one, which is a Scotch laminating machine at home. And I'm honestly not too big of a fan of this one because it has a very tight space for you to put in the laminating sheet. So if it's crooked, like it just messes up your paper. So I don't recommend this laminator, but it's like my classroom one, so I use it when I need to. And I know to be mindful about how I'm putting the paper inside. And then when I was teaching pre-K, I forgot what these are called, but they are from Lakeshore. I would put a whiteboard here. I had tables in pre-K. So for example, if students were working on a particular theme vocabulary, then I would put a whiteboard here with all of the vocabulary for their writing, so I'm not using them this year. And then these are just stamps that I've ended up with over the years from Lakeshore. This little bucket I got also from the Target dollar spot, and this is like my random pen. So when I have like parent-teacher conferences or meet and greet, just something where I have a lot of people in my classroom, I put this one out so they can get a writing utensil from here and not from my personal ones. Now this is a little bit more disorganized, but I'm gonna try to go through it. I like having my own label maker, and I use it to label like big bins like this. For example, I wrote what I have inside of my bins. I always like to have this packaging Scotch tape and masking tape as well. I have more magnetic tape. I cannot have enough magnetic tape. This is a random container that I ended up with. I have colorful laces, little tongs also from Lakeshore. I don't use Velcro too much, so I just have like this little pack. I have like glue sticks for my glue gun. More glue sticks for my glue gun, which should be in here, but I think I kept it at home for a project right now. This is just random stuff that I kept from last year. Have any space to put my little personal pictures. Now I'm going to show you, this is probably my most disorganized bin and I still need to finish labeling it. But in here I have just a bunch of extra stuff. I have thank you cards. You never know when you need to write like a last minute thank you card. I have crafting sticks. I have these red jumbo pencils also from Lakeshore. I really love these because they last me the whole year. I assign one to each student. You don't have to sharpen them as often. And this is just like a camera that I use to record my lessons sometimes. I have markers. These are just my own personal markers whenever I need to make anchor charts and stuff like that. I have blank index cards. This is more ink that I have. I'm pretty good about not using up all my classroom ink. These are extra pink and gray chunky crayons that I ordered from Amazon. This is like a random little hole puncher that's star-shaped. I have batteries, big old batteries, envelopes. This is random. I got this from student teaching. I just haven't like used all of the material yet. I have my crayons. I have more kinds of like duct tape that was also given to me when I was student teaching. I have a screwdriver. You never know. Like I have actually used a screwdriver a couple times throughout the year. I have USB sticks that I won in like a little school raffle. Command hooks. I have pins, fasteners, binder rings in different sizes, some fancy markers, reinforcement tape, more fasteners. I see like push pins. This is all stuff that I've used at some point, but I think that's kind of it for this random bin. This is a little bin that I reuse whenever I bought Lace Award lowercase beads. This is just more random Velcro, rubber bands, and just a bunch of binder clips. And these are well labeled. I have paper clips, whiteout, and a whole bunch of tape, different kinds of tape. And this is basically like my lifetime supply of sticky notes because I don't use that many sticky notes. So this is just like a bunch that I've ended up with over the years. And these bins I ended up with from student teaching. This also goes in here, but I bought this last year because it was really noisy at dismissal. So this helped for dismissal. And I also used it in the classroom and for recess. And it has a siren option. It's like just a really loud alarm and they know to stop and listen to me when I turn it on. I have not used it this year. I haven't found it necessary since I have way less kids in the classroom. And this stuff is basically like my pre-K stuff that I use for dramatic play that I'm not able to use in kinder. Here at the bottom, my tape dispenser, my stapler. This is my small group caddy. But since I'm not doing small group at my table, I haven't really used it. But what I keep in my small group caddy either way, little magnetic dry erase boards, some dry erase markers, a timer, little erasers. I have a cup with more dry erase markers. And these are tactile numbers. I also have these little mirrors. Since I teach English language learners, sometimes they have trouble pronouncing certain words or a certain sound, so we look at our mouth movement in the mirror and talk about what our mouth should be doing for that sound or that word. And I have these little cards. I don't remember where I got them from, but they're kind of just for fluency. It's depending on what group is at my table, they'll either practice their letter recognition fluency or their letter sound fluency. I have more little number flashcards that I got from the dollar spot at Target at some point. I have these color cards. Some of my kids do not know their colors, but that's kind of all that's in my small group caddy. And this caddy I just kind of ended up with, so it's really awesome. I did not buy it. It was in my classroom. This was actually, I saved all of my vocabulary cards from last year. This is a random lamp that was not very bright. I should have just not gotten it, but it was $5. One of my favorite dramatic plays that I used to do in pre-K was for astronauts for outer space, so I got them helmets. I have some bugs whenever we studied about insects for the sensory bin. I have just random eggs that I haven't repurposed. This is a little Santa mailbox that I got last year from Target. And another really awesome center was for a theme that was called Choices. So we talked about healthy choices, unhealthy choices, going to doctor visits. So I would set up a doctor's office. I loved it so much. This is like stuff that they used, like a stethoscope. We have bandaging tape, a fake vaccine, fake medicine that I brought from home. It's empty. This was like one of my writing centers last year. So this went with the Santa letters. Have pictures of actual toys. When the kids were writing their Santa letters, they could write what they wanted. I don't remember where this resource is from, but I will link it. And I still have like little envelopes. So this center I will do this year. I got these little safety vests for dramatic play as well, and we used them for construction and for a recycling center as well. Oh, and then the band-aids were also part of. I bought just this big old pack of band-aids whenever they did the doctor. I don't know how I ended up with this bin, but I did, and I used it to store more stuff. So this is also for transportation, I believe. I used these for transportation in a sensory bin and for construction. These are sea animals whenever we talked about ocean animals. This is more transportation. And oh man, I really loved, yeah, the construction center. So I bought these two little boxes. I think it was two or three boxes of black Decker tools, and they were not that expensive. Got them from Target. I will link those too, but it was really awesome. Like, these were all just hands-on tools. This is the little telescope. This was also for outer space. And this is like a class set of bandanas that I ordered my first year because I had an incident where a couple of my students got lost at like my very first field trip. They were just lost for like a couple of minutes, but there was lots of cops there. Long story short, I bought these bandanas and I tie them on my kids so that they're easy to spot on field trips. All right, so we're basically done with this side of my closet. And on this side, I do have extra teacher clothes. I mentioned in one of my videos, I think it was my advice to new pre-K and kinder teachers, that I sat on kid pee my first year of teaching. One of my kids had peed on the carpet and I didn't know. And I sat in it, and at least it was towards the end of the day. But now I know that I keep an extra pair of pants, extra shirt, and then I just have a couple of sweatshirts. This is more organized chaos. These are pizza boxes that I want to use for a math center at some point. These are just random posters that I don't need right now. I have some paper gift bags. This is where I keep all of my bulletin board. I promise it's organized. I'm not like super OCD when it comes to organization. I just need to know where my things are, which I do. So that's not a problem for me. I have a little bit more laminating sheets. But yeah, this is all just border. I get most of my border from Lakeshore, and I try to reuse it as many times as possible. And then I also really just like to buy my own bulletin paper. That is it for what's in my teacher closet. So I hope you got some ideas on just teacher supplies that you might need in the future. Thank you so much for watching. Please share with your teacher friends. Like if you got some helpful ideas. And subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video.